All right, on to something new. Survival function of a client. What's a client? Well, think business. If you're in the business world, your customer is your client. Rarely do people do business with newborn babies, right? At least not directly. Usually, insurance companies are doing business with people that are at least 20 years old. That's what the X in parentheses is supposed to represent. An X-year-old. X is 20, it's a 20-year-old. Weird, but somewhat standard notation and terminology here. Okay, suppose a newborn baby of lifetime capital T has survival function given by, oh, where'd it go? That part of the slide is not there. Given by sigma of T, it's not there. It's a phantom sigma of T. It's not showing up here. Assume that another person, a client, is at age X. Let T of X represent the remaining lifetime of this client. If we assume, and this is an assumption that I didn't really put in there, but perhaps I should have. If we assume that capital T as a random variable, as a theoretical random variable with a PDF and a CDF and a survival function, is a good model for a newborn baby, we could also make another assumption that T minus X would be a good model for this client for the remaining lifetime. Okay, pretend you're, maybe some of you are 20 years old. Maybe you're 20.43298 years old. Okay, what's your remaining lifetime? Well, if you die when you are 80.28, I forgot what I said for the decimal part, then your remaining lifetime is 60 years. That's like the observed value of T of X. X for you is 20 point whatever. T of X, the observed value, imagining we go in the future and we can see when you die, would be your observed value of your remaining lifetime. That would be 60. That would be the same as how long you lived from birth minus your current age. The 80 point something minus 20 point, the same thing, would be 60. Now, that's not a guarantee that this is a good idea from a modeling perspective, to say that T of X should be related to T in this way. But it certainly seems like the simplest thing to try and hope it's a good model. It's probably not a good model, actually, right? Secret be told. In part, you might say because of infant mortality, for one thing. You know, some babies, more than used to be the case, have a pretty high chance of dying within their first month or so. Modern medicine has made that better, has definitely reduced infant mortality. But 100 years ago, it was a big thing. Lots of women lost babies either in childbirth or shortly after. Sometimes to disease, sometimes to just lack of sanitation, that kind of thing. Or a lack of care. What's the survival function for this client X? Got any intuition here about how we should figure out the survival function for the remaining lifetime random variable here, T of X? Any intuition about a general approach? I'm thinking perhaps of an idea from chapter 2, whose initials are CP, and that doesn't stand for class participation. Conditional probability. This is the common conditional probability to think about it first. And the notation you see on the left, pre-subscript T, P subscript X, is the most common notation out there in actuarial science. TPX, this is called the conditional survival function for a client age X. I'm also using the notation sigma sub X of T to be consistent with our previous notation for sigma, but I will tell you the notation on the left is the most common thing you'll find in actuarial science books. It's a conditional probability. It's the conditional probability that, okay, think conceptually here. Think of little x and little t is given, okay? Pretend little x is, you know, 20.4, say. That's your current age. And little t is you're wondering about the probability that you're going to survive at least another 60 years. So maybe little t is exactly 60. Thinking about this notation, that is the conditional probability that you, this client of age 20.4, say, if x is 20.4, is greater than 60, given that you made it to your current age. Now, technically speaking, when you think about such a probability, you really should think of it in the context of newborn babies. This baby has just been born. I wonder what the probability is that they're going to live 60 years past, at least 60 years past 20.4 years of age. From a modeling perspective, what we're doing here, it's best to model it that way. But insurance companies, for example, life insurance companies, do go ahead and use this for people who are already 20.4 years old, because it's just the simplest thing to try. And you have to assess whether it's really accurate or not based on data. From the definition of conditional probability, right? What is the definition of conditional probability? The conditional probability of A given B is, by definition, the probability of A intersect B, A and B, divided by the probability of B. Thinking of A and B as being subsets of the sample space, that was the notation we used back in chapter 2. I'm using that here with a little, some step skip. Maybe I should show those steps here. So we're after the conditional probability that T of X is greater than T, given that T itself is greater than or equal to X. So, you know, I'm not writing these things as sets. We're being less formal there. This is the event that the remaining lifetime of a client age X is at least T more years, say, if time is in years, given that they have already lived to age X, which they would have since they're your client, right? They're sitting there across from your desk and you're trying to sell them an insurance policy. Using this formula, that's the same as the probability. Okay, I'll use curly braces, but still not very precise notation here. So think of these as sets. This is the probability of the event T of X being greater than T intersect with the event T is greater than or equal to X, divided by the probability that T is greater than or equal to X. But what is T of X? I define this to be T minus X. If X is something specific, this is a random variable because T is a random variable. X, you're thinking of as being a specific number. And so this event could be rewritten as the event that T minus X is greater than little t, which is also the same as the event that capital T is greater than little t plus little x. What's the intersection of this event with that event? The intersection of the events that I'm pointing at. This event right there is contained in this one, right? Assuming little t is positive. So their intersection is just this event. Excuse me, I said that wrong. This event is contained in that one. If X is 20.4 and T is 60, this would be the event that the newborn baby lives at least 80.4 years. This is the event that they live at least 20.4 years. If they live at least 80.4 years, they definitely lived at least 20.4 years. This is a subset of that. So their intersection is just this. Again, this is making the assumption that using defining T of X in this way is a good thing to do from a modeling perspective. We're making an assumption. In reality, it's probably not, but it's a good first attempt. So it's the probability, take the intersection of these two things and you'll just get this thing, that capital T is bigger than little t plus X, divided by the probability that capital T is greater than or equal to X. And again, capital T is a continuous random variable. I could also replace that by a greater than or equal to. This is related to the survival function. This is sigma of T plus X divided by sigma of X. That's what's in the PowerPoint here. So effectively, it's a new kind of survival function from an old kind of survival function. And all the other formulas for the mean, for the second moment, and therefore for the variance and standard deviation, can get updated to this conditional setting. Just use this survival function. Take one minus it to get it the corresponding conditional CDF. Take its negative derivative to find the conditional PDF. You can integrate T times that PDF to find the mean. You could also use the Darth Vader rule and just integrate this function itself. You could consider the corresponding curtate remaining lifetime. Round down, take the greatest integer in T of X. And that's all discussed in the handout, okay? Just update those formulas.